been working for 15 years in bamboo. I'm basically a scientist from rice like Dr. Narayan, and I did work with sugarcane, banana, rose, carnation, jeebra, like these 85 different species, and worked, tired, started working with bamboo for 15 years, converted that into an excellent commercial crop. It can give more money than tea, more money than rubber, more money than rice, sugarcane. Sugarcane is supposed to be a cash crop, 35,000 rupees per acre. Bamboo can give you a minimum 1 lakh rupee per acre per year. As simple firewood. It could be anything, anything. It can make a lot of things, right? I just looking at Thai, when I want to come and speak to Thai, I said, let me talk only the investment opportunity. What is the technology available? What is happening? Where is happening in India and in the bamboo sector? Yeah, thank you. And bamboo, when you say bamboo, there are a lot of products are there. Charcoal, laptop, cycle, bio-CNG, charcoal. It could be, you know, can you switch off these two lights? It's not really good for this. You don't need the light. Yeah, thank you. Now it looks better. Now, you know, it could be even textile. What I'm wearing, it could be cotton bamboo. Cotton is available 500 kilograms per acre per year. Bamboo can give you 10,000 kilograms per year, per acre. And for which you have to plant only once. It can be harvested for next 10, 15, 20, 30, 100 years. I don't think this light is needed. And bamboo is next switching over for the fossil fuel. I mean, all industry has got requirement, but then the requirement is huge. Nobody can satisfy is the energy sector. And bamboo today is being grown as energy plantation, like tea plantation, rubber plantation, coffee plantation. It's grown as an energy plantation where it's going to produce electricity, coal, biofuel, bioethanol, bio-CNG, like a petrol, diesel. That is what the technology breakthrough. Today we are also working in converting into hydrogen for a hydrogen fuel cell. And all this is going to bring a lot of challenges, and this is for the better future. To make this country carbon neutral. The fastest growing plant on the earth is bamboo. 1.5 feet every day. No plant grows. But unfortunately, no agriculture has been done in this field. I did a doctorate in agriculture, but then finally, you know, we have to come and check up for what is the possible. Like, it has got an energy value of 4,000 kilocalorie. And ash content, coal has got energy, but 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 kilocalorie, but the ash is 20-30%. Bamboo has got only 1% ash. And that's the beauty, because it's nature's gift, it's available with us. And bamboo is cut like this, and you can convert the bamboo into electricity. And what do you need? 200 acres of bamboo plantation can produce 1 megawatt electricity every hour, 24 hours, 365 days from 200 acres. What you need is 1 kg will produce 1 kilowatt current. 1 ton is needed for 1 megawatt electricity. And at a cost of 2.5 rupees, we buy minimum 5 rupees 50 paise. As industry, we pay 8 rupees 50 paise. And it could be produced at 2.5 rupees. And green energy, that's the beauty of it. And because of the shortage of time, I'm just putting all the nutshell to just throw you, wake you up, and you are in a big opportunity industries. Lot of money. Look at, like this bamboo can be converted into cellulose. Cellulose can be converted to ethanol. Bamboo has got more than 65% cellulose. All that could be digested, and ultimately within a week's time, it could be converted into petrol. How much? 4 kg bamboo can make 1.2 liter. And 1 acre can produce 10,000 liter ethanol. Today we get ethanol for drinking, for industrial use, for the vehicle to be added for the fuel. And it's only 450 liter per acre from sugarcane. We get 40 tons of sugarcane. When you crush it, you're getting only around 4 tons of sugar. 100 tons of molasses waste, and that is converted into ethanol. That we get only around 450 liter. Bamboo can give you 10,000 liter every year. This is with the present day technology. And then comes the gas. CNG gas. If you go to Delhi, you got a lot of CNG gas being produced. Now, bamboo can produce the CNG gas, and this is the one of the plant in Pune which is able to produce this gas. You know, this is the bamboo which is used, fermented in the column for one day, not 20, just 24 hours, and then it's converted into gas. The gas has got all the other things like CO2, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide. Then it's put into cylinder, and that is distributed. 4 kg makes 1 kg of bio CNG gas. And 1 acre can produce 4,000 kg of the gas, and this is what happens there. The bunk is there in the front, and it is getting dispensed now continuously. It's happening in Pune, and this is, it can use bamboo, it can use tea waste, it can use rubber waste, it can use any agriculture waste, paddy straw, corn, anything can be done. Not only that, the next level of technology is convert bamboo into oil. Oil is simple, easy commodity to carry over from one place to another place. So it's been converted into oil. 4 kilos of bamboo makes again 1 kilo oil, and a byproduct is charcoal, activated bamboo charcoal. And now Shell has taken this technology now, converted that into a IH2 technology. The IH2 technology, they had done a research in the beginning to convert few kilograms, and then they went on doing the research on this. Now they have a unit which is able to do 5,000 kilograms a day into petrol or diesel. 5,000 kg of biomass converted into 1,000 kg of petrol or diesel. This is the latest technology, and you can produce so much instead of importing it. And that is called biodiesel, or you can just remove bio, it's diesel directly. And now right now we're working on the technology of converting bamboo into hydrogen, because when you produce CH4, the C is knocked out and hydrogen is comes. Hydrogen fuel cell is the next in the future, because it doesn't give any emission, no pollution at all, because the pollution is going to be only water, pure water coming out from this. Hydrogen combined with oxygen, you're going to get water out of this. And all this happening because of the high energy value of the bamboo, which I said it's got low ash content. And look at the coal, simple coal. Let's not go into high technology. Let us replace the coal. Today, the coal can be replaced with the help of the bamboo. Bamboo can be converted to either charcoal or a bamboo directly can be used. Today, if you look at India, we have 820 million tons we are using it, out of which 200 million tons we are importing it from abroad. And 200 million tons, you can just simply change into 200 million tons of bamboo because it's got the same energy value. Why I am showing this is, bamboo cannot be satisfied for this country. If you just want to replace the imported bamboo, you need at least cultivated bamboo, you need 5 million acres of bamboo. It's more than the sugarcane area in the country. Just to replace coal, look at then ethanol, diesel, hydrogen, or all the things, it's huge requirement. We cannot even satisfy. That is the kind of requirement. All these for which we are paying our Indian rupee into dollars. And our dollar is going up. So the advantage of bamboo is you can keep on producing bamboo at 4,000 kilocalorie. Ash is very low, and every year you can harvest the bamboo. Once in 100 years only need to replant them. You don't need to replant them at all every time. Low tar biomass. If bioprojects fails, you can make so many things out of the bamboo. You know, bamboo today is like this. That is the reason bamboo is never considered. It is in the forest, only giving 0.5 tons per acre. We have 12.5 million. Tons of bamboo coming from bamboo in India from 13.9 million hectare, 1 ton per hectare or 0.4 tons per acre. That is in the forest. That is the reason it's not coming up. But if you cultivate, I've seen in Kerala a lot of these bamboo is grown. You grow like this, it is there, but it's able to give around 4 to 8 tons per acre. Today, what Dr. Narayan said, precision farming. Precision farming, bamboo grows like this. Line crop like a sugar cane. That is what done in the last 15 years, and that is able to give 40 tons per acre per year. 40 tons, like sugar cane. Cut it and sell it as a firewood. It will give you 4,000 rupees firewood price. 1,60,000 rupees per acre. 40,000 is expenditure. 1,20,000 is the net margin. Take it as 1 lakh rupee. Which crop can give you 1 lakh rupee with a less labor and non-perishable product, and you could be absent landlord? The bamboo grows at a speed of 1.5 feet a day. I just recorded and showing this for you for information. Can you just stick this in the screen? 1.5 feet a bamboo grows. Yeah, just click it. Yeah. One more click. Look at that. This is started in the evening, 6 o'clock. The clock is there. It started 6 o'clock. It has gone through this. Now at night, morning it has come. Still it's growing. Afternoon, 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and it has grown 1.5 feet. It keeps growing, for the whole week, whole month, and reaches 40, 45 feet in 1 month's time. It's the fastest growing plant on the earth. That made me to start working in bamboo. That bamboo can produce any quantity of biomass, any quantity of wood, and it can convert sun energy into energy. Now, bamboo to produce 40 tons, you need a good bamboo species, good clone. When you say good clone, you see them, the normal bamboo. On the left-hand side, the bamboo which is developed specifically for this. I named it as Bhima bamboo. And that's got a thick wall, heavy weight. I got a sample here to show you. And bamboo need to be propagated properly. Tissue culture, I know A.V. Thomas and Company, 1976 itself, they are the first people, 86 itself, the first company to develop the tissue culture in India, in the world. And it has been doing very well. And in that case, bamboo also is one of the crop. In fact, I was associated with this, A.B. Thomas and Company in the beginning, and this is a tissue culture of bamboo. Tissue culture of bamboo is produced in large quantity, every day 1 lakh plant. I am habitual tissue culture specialist, I have been producing this plant, and this is produced and exported throughout the world. People are planting it everywhere, and this is a greenhouse full of bamboo, that bamboo. And the next, what is important is not tissue culture plant alone, the agriculture practice to grow them properly, and the high density plantation. This is a plantation of bamboo, and you can see them 1 month crop. Line crop with the drip irrigation, it is planted and then the lines are there, and a dry land. It's not like a place like Kerala. Kerala is beautiful. You don't need to have drip. The nature is given so much more, a good climatic condition. Look at the same plant, in 1 month is this, in 4 months, in 8 months, growing so fast, covering up. The 12 feet gap is reduced to 1 foot, and in another 4 months, 12 months, gone fully. Completely covered. No sun is wasted. It becomes a single solar panel, continuously absorbing it and storing it in the bamboo, and that can be converted into electricity anytime. 24 hours electricity can be produced out of the bamboo. And the next is the drip irrigation. All these activities do, we will be able to produce this electricity easily. From 200 acres, you can produce 1 megawatt. And just to show you, what is the, this is a small gasifier, 5 kilowatt, and this is a 500 kilowatt. You can go up to 5 megawatt electricity from bamboo. Every 200 acres can produce one electricity. If you want to put up this project, you need 200 acres. The process is pyrolysis, and it produces 8,000 megawatt hours in a year. And the byproduct is charcoal. Charcoal also will give you money. And the production is, you produce REC, Renewable Energy Certificate. Let me show you the, this is the people who came from South Africa. They've seen this. They went back to South Africa in Durban. They planted this as a first national demonstration project in 1,250 acres. And if somebody wants to put a bamboo project, and this is the schedule of that. Plantation first 2 years, third year onwards the harvest starts, and in the second year itself, you should put the project should be established in the second year. Third year onwards, you start getting the power. Now look at the investment, what you need. You need 2.5 crore rupees for the first year, 8.6 for the second year, and then you have operation cost of 1.5 crores, 1.5 crore every year. And for this, you'll be able to make a revenue from the power of 7,000 megawatt hours, 3 crores, up to 3.5 crores every year. The byproduct is charcoal, and the charcoal will give you another 0.8 crore rupees. And you have REC, Renewable Energy Certificate, for 7,000 megawatt hours. That will give you another 4.3 crore rupees. Total revenue comes to around 4.3 crore rupees. And your profit before margin, PBIT, is 2.8 crore rupees. And within 3 years, your money will come back to you. That is the fastest project ever. And there is no marketing needed for the power project. And if somebody is cultivating the bamboo, you need 1 lakh rupees for the first year, 30,000 rupees for the second year, 40,000 rupees for the fourth year onwards, third year onwards. I'll show you the entire thing for, this is a table for the first year, second year, third year, fourth year. For 10 years, you end up in spending 4 lakh rupees per acre. And the biomass what you're going to get is 30 tons first year, 35 tons, third year, fourth year, and fifth year onwards, 40 tons. And you are getting at 1,344 rupees. Your firewood price is 4,000 rupees. Bamboo can be sold as incense stick, which is around 1 lakh rupee a ton. Toothpick, 10 lakh rupees a ton. Forget about all that. Firewood, simple biomass will be able to give you the money. And it can be converted into oil, which I told you in the beginning itself. And this is a shell technology. Since the bell is rang, I'm going to rush it through this. Just to tell you, sugarcane is giving only 500 liter. Maize in USA is giving only 3,000 liter. Bamboo is the future. Plant only once. Sugarcane has to be planted once in 2 years. Maize has to be planted three times a year. Bamboo has to be planted only once in 100 years. Will give you 10,000 liter ethanol. This is the future technology. Already practices are coming up. And this is a process. I don't want to go into the detail. My bell is rang. And these are the process. Gentlemen, can I take another 5 more minutes or close it? Sorry? Thank you. You know, this is a process. This is an investment. Somebody is looking at ethanol as a project. First 2 years is a plantation time. You can start cutting bamboo in 2 years' time. Not like 5-6 years. Those are all old in technology, like growing chicken at the house. They'll go on his own, eat, come back, and 1 year, you'll get 1 kg chicken. Today, we have broiler chicken. Ready in 42 days' time. You feed in the daytime, nighttime, with tube light. That's what is broiler bamboo. And that can give you those kind of, harvesting from here, investment for the bioethanol. The project starts from here. You invest in something like, you know, close to around 208 crore rupees. With the operation margin of 25 crore rupees, you have a profit margin of 56 crore rupees. And you just produce it, people are there to sign for next 20, 30 years. IOC needs it, Bharat Petroleum needs it, everybody will sign it at 60 rupees a liter at once. And you have a payback period of 3.5 years' time. No project can give this. And what you need is a good bamboo. And Kerala is the right place for bamboo. Bamboo is there everywhere. I just came to the hotel, I saw bamboo there. Everywhere bamboo, but we don't cultivate the bamboo for this purpose. And what you need is, this is a CNG gas which I told you, I just going to skip it. And bamboo produces huge quantity of carbon sequestration. Carbon is sequestered. 40 tons of bamboo produces 23 tons of carbon, because full of carbon, 50% carbon, and releases, it captures 84 tons of carbon dioxide. Releases 61 tons of oxygen. Very, very important. How Bisleri bottle is there everywhere. Next is going to be oxygen, oxygen, oxygen everywhere. And this oxygen is going to be short supply. Bamboo produces huge quantity of oxygen, and that one tree produces 320 kgs of oxygen. One human being needs only 280 kilograms. One tree, one human being, lungs is sufficient. That is the beauty of bamboo. But we never recorded all this. We are seen everywhere. And put few plants outside, next to the house, you'll be able to do that. Today, it's coming as an oxygen park. This is in Mangalore. And my next project coming up in Trichy, 100 acres of oxygen park. Go to the net, you'll be able to see that. Oxygen park. It's coming for people to walk around. And this is what the future of bamboo, and the bamboo can make one bamboo tree if you plant it next to your house. Forget about the industry. If you plant one tree next to the bamboo, it can take 450 kg of carbon dioxide, release 320 kg of oxygen. It can take all your sewage water, 6,000 liter, one septic tank water. It can suck it and it can grow into nice tree into this, and it can cool 1 ton of air conditioned load. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for giving extra 5 minutes.